She kind of reminds me of like a Rosie the Riveter, you know, but she has a cigarette in her mouth and she's talking to you while she's got the cigarette, you know, held in the corner of her mouth. And then she'll say, you know what I mean?
We're like day and night and we get along like so well, you know, we can't even each other out.
She reminded me of my wife, that she means what she says what she means.
First time I met him, he walked up and he asked me how he could get a job on the forklift.
And I was about to change, just, you know, to work in her department, simply because she had a work ethic.
We were informed months ahead of time that we were going to be losing 600 jobs. So I was working every minute of overtime that I could possibly get. Just one day, I couldn't pick my head up off the pillow. I couldn't get up. I started crying hysterically. Within 3 months of that incident, I had lost all my hair everywhere. Nobody could actually say what happened. They just say stress.
The gloom hung thick like a cloud. And then the word came.
You have to turn in your uniforms, your keys.
It was horribly controlled, like you were in a prison camp.
As I'm walking out, the more people I said goodbye to, the more I was crying.
For me, leaving at 3 o'clock in the morning, it was a very long ride home.
It's no lie. They make billions of dollars profit on just this one cookie, the Oreo.
When greed gets married to that type of business model, it is like an atomic bomb. It leaves no skin on the bone.
But they want more. I mean, how much more do you really, how much more do you need? How much more? And make it off of my back and then disregard me like I'm nothing? The only people that can stop this is us, the Americans, the American people, the American consumer. We start demanding to buy American-made products, then that's what we'll get.